हेलो एवरीवन, हाउ आर यू ऑल? होप यू आर सेफ एंड साउंड। यू मस्ट हैव एंजॉयड योर वेकेशन आल्सो। बिफोर द वेकेशन स्टार्ट, वी हैव स्टार्टेड विद द फर्स्ट चैप्टर। वी फिनिश द प्रेपोजिशंस एंड देन वी स्टार्टेड विद द फर्स्ट चैप्टर। इन द फर्स्ट चैप्टर वी हैव डन वन पैराग्राफ ऑफ फैबियो एंड रिवाइज द कंजंक्शन वेन। You have also solved the exercise based on that conjunction when. Now today we are going to learn the new conjunction infinitive plus su. This conjunction is used to combine the infinitive sentences. Infinitive sentences are the subordinate clauses here without a subject. Now what do you mean by infinitive sentences? Infinitive sentences are the sentences in which the verb is in its infinitive form. What do you mean by in its infinitive form? It means it is in its original form. Whenever the verb is in its original form, at that time it is an infinitive sentence. These infinitive sentences refer to a person or thing in the main clause. These infinitive sentences refer to a person or thing which is already included or mentioned in the main clause. The subordinate clause ends with the verb in its infinitive form. That means this subordinate clause ends with a verb in the original form. And before that verb, su must be placed. By the way, su is not here a preposition. It is used as a conjunction and it must be placed before the verb. The verb should be at the end of the sentence in the original form. If you remember, when we have solved when sentences, we put the verb in its conjugated form. But here it is in the infinitive form. This conjunction is called as infinitive plus su. Now let's see few examples of this. This is the sentence here. Hast du Lust mit mir ins Kino gehen? Means, are you interested to come with me in the theater? In this sentence, you can see the most important thing is kein Subjekt im Nebensatz. The subject of this sentence is du, but which is not mentioned once again in the subordinate clause. As the subject is same in the both the sentences, it is not required to mention the subject once again in the subordinate clause. Now, you can see here, Hast du Lust is the main clause. Mit mir ins Kino zu gehen is the subordinate clause. In this subordinate clause, gehen is the verb at the end of the sentence im infinitive. That means in its original form. And zu is used before gehen. Zu vor dem gehen. So whenever you combine the sentence with zu plus gehen or zu plus infinitive plus zu, the verb should be in infinitive at the end of the sentence and before verb zu must be used. And what is written in this box? Yes. Comma should be placed between Hauptsatz and Nebensatz. This is the requirement of all subordinate clauses that there must be comma between Hauptsatz. Hauptsatz bedeutet main clause and Nebensatz bedeutet subordinate clause. So the comma must be placed between subordinate clause and main clause. Now let's see one more example. Here the example is of trennbare Verben. Trennbare Verben means separable verbs. What happens when it is a separable verb? I will read the example. Ich habe vergessen das Fenster aufzumachen. I forgot to close the window or to open the window. Sorry, aufmachen is to open, zumachen is to close. So I forgot to open the window. Here, Ich habe vergessen is the main clause. Main clause always comes at the beginning here. So, Ich habe vergessen is the main clause. Aufzumachen is the verb at the end of the subordinate clause im infinitive, in the original form. And zu is placed between prefix and verb. Whenever there is a separable verb, So must be placed between prefix and verb. And you can see here that aufzumachen is written as a one word. In the last sentence, zugehen was written separately. But in case of separable verb, when you add zu, it becomes as a one word. So always it must be written together. So according to what these two sentences, what we have concluded that in the subordinate clause, verb should go at the end in the original form. And before that verb, zu must be placed. Now we will see when do we use these sentences. When one benutzt man infinitive plus zu. When what are the requirements when this infinitive plus zu comes? Infinitive plus zu can be used only after certain nouns, verbs, and adjectives. There are three sets of nouns, verbs, and adjectives after which infinitive plus zu can be used. Let's see the first set. First set is of verbs. I will explain you meanings of these verbs first. Anfangen is to begin, aufhören is to stop, beginnen is to begin, bieten is to request, erlauben is to allow, hoffen is to hope, planen is to plan, raten is to guess, sich freuen is to be happy about, vergessen is to forget, versuchen is to try, vorhaben is to plan, and vorschlagen is to suggest. One example I will give in of any one verb. For example, hoffen. Ich hoffe nächstes Jahr nach Deutschland zu fahren. I hope to travel to Germany next year. In English, infinitive zu is equivalent like to. In English also, we don't repeat the subject once again in subordinate clause. So, ich hoffe nächstes Jahr nach Deutschland zu fahren. This is one example. Now let's see the second set of nouns plus haben. These nouns are used only with haben. Zeit haben, to have time. The example of Zeit haben is Ich habe keine Zeit ins Kino zu gehen. I have no time to go to cinema hall. Lust haben is to have mood or to be interested. Angst haben is to be afraid of or to have a fear. Recht haben is to be right. Absicht haben is to have a view of something. Interesse haben, to have interest. Sinn haben is to have a sense of something. Keinen Sinn haben means it is senseless. Es hat keinen Sinn hier zu laufen or hier zu warten. Okay, now let's see the third set. Third set is of adjectives which come with sein or finden. First one is es ist wichtig, it is important. Es ist verboten, it is prohibited. Verboten is prohibited. Es ist nicht leicht, it is not easy. Es ist schwer, it is difficult. Ich finde es interessant, I find it interesting. Es ist schwierig. Schwierig und schwer sind Synonyme. Schwierig and schwer are the synonyms. Es ist erlaubt. It is allowed. Es ist gesund. It is healthy. Es ist gefährlich. It is dangerous. Let's see one or two sentences of this adjective. For example, es ist gesund. Es ist gesund, gemüse und aufzuessen. It is healthy to eat fruits and vegetables. Or, es ist nicht leicht, Japanisch zu lernen. It is not easy to learn Japanese. So, these are the three sets which you have to keep in mind that these verbs, nouns, adjectives always take infinitive plus zu. So, that's why this list is important. Now, let's go ahead with one example. How do we use infinitive plus zu? That I will explain you now. Ich hoffe, dass ich in der Prüfung gute Punkte bekomme. I hope that I am getting good marks. I will get good marks in the exam. this sentence will be combined with two in English like this. Ish, I hope to get good marks in the exam. In English also, ish is removed. Similarly, in German, this das and ish should be dropped. So the sentence will be ich hoffe. That is the main clause, comma. In der Prüfung, gute Punkte bekommen will go at the end of the sentence in the original form, in its infinitive form. And before bekommen, zu must be placed. So, ich hoffe in der Prüfung, gute Punkte zu bekommen. Then, you can see the meaning of both the sentences same. So, das setze und infinitive plus zu setze sind gleich. Gleich means same. That sentences and infinitive plus zu sentences are same in meaning. Here, I have written one note for you that is important one. Subordinate clause with infinitive plus zu comes usually after the main clause. Main clause should be at the beginning of the sentence. Since both the clauses have the same subject, it is not repeated in the subordinate clause. That is the most important thing. That the subject is not repeated in the subordinate clause. That's why this type of conjunction form, this type of infinitive plus zu is applicable only if the subject is same in the both the sentence. If I am saying that I hope that my sister will get good marks in the exam, I can't combine that sentence with infinitive plus zu. For that, subject must be same in the both the sentences. Now let's go ahead. Here I want to explain you few sentences how to combine infinitive plus zu. So benutzt infinitive plus zu. Let's see the first sentence. Es macht mir Spaß. It gives me fun. And in the bracket it is written, ein leckeres Essen zu kochen. Lecker means tasty. To cook, it gives me fun to cook a tasty food. We have to combine the part which is given in the bracket with infinitive plus zu. Now, already in that bracket part, subject is not mentioned, so there is no need of removing it. Only kochen is the verb which will go at the end of the sentence, and before kochen, zu must be placed. So the answer will be, es macht mir Spaß, comma, is must. Ein leckeres Essen zu kochen. So it is a must to cook. It gives me fun to cook a tasty food. Now let's see the second example. In the second example, the sentence is given. Wir finden es toll, dass wir einen Monat lang Urlaub haben. We find it excellent that we have 1 month vacation. So, here wir, the subject is same in both the sentences. So, in English, the sentence will be like this. We find it excellent to have 1 month long vacation. Now, when we combine this sentence, we will remove this das and we will remove wir also. So, the answer will be, wir finden es toll, that is the main clause, comma, einen Monat lang Urlaub. Haben will go at the end of the sentence in the original form and zu will be placed before that. So, the answer is wir finden es toll, einen Monat lang Urlaub zu haben. This was the second sentence. Now, let's see the third example. Third example is in form of question and answer. Hast du Zeit, kommst du ins Kino? Do you have time? Do you come in the theater? Nein, ich habe keine Zeit. In English, how it will be? No, I have no time to come in the theater. So, to come is the verb that is common, which will go at the end of the sentence in the original form. And before that comment, zu must be placed. So, the answer will be, Nein, ich habe keine Zeit ins Kino zu kommen. No, I have no time to come in the theater. Now, purposely here, I have given three types. First type is the sentence is given in the bracket. Second one is the sentence. Third one is in the form of question and answer. I explained you here these sentences so that it will be easier for you to solve the given worksheet. That's why I explain you these three types. Now, is it so that always infinitive comes with so? No, it is not so. There is one important learning tip I want to give you, that infinitive is used without so after modal verbs, lassen, bleiben and gehen. In case of these four cases, modal verbs are six modal verbs. Lassen means to let, bleiben is to stay, and gehen is to go. In these four cases, zu is not used. Now let's see the example of the same. Zum Beispiel, ich will heute ins Kino gehen. Will is a modal verb. I hope you remember in 7th standard whenever you learn the modal verbs. The auxiliary verb always go at the end of the sentence in its original form. So, ich will heute ins Kino gehen. I want to go to theater today. No zu is used. Now, the second sentence. Lassen uns zusammen morgen treffen. Let's meet together tomorrow. Morgen is M small, so it is tomorrow. Lassen is to let. And here, treffen is used without zu. Because not required, so is not required. Let's meet together tomorrow morning. Not morning, tomorrow. The student is bestraft. Bestraft is punished. The student is punished. Er soll den ganzen Tag stehen bleiben. He should stand for the whole day. Here also there is no zu between stehen and bleiben. Then the fourth example is jeden Tag gehe ich schwimmen. Here also zu is not required. I go for swimming. Oder tanzen gehen, spielen gehen, shoppen gehen. Here zu is not required. So in case of these four types, you have to keep in mind that zu is not required. Along with this video, I will send you the notes of this chapter on this grammar topic. You need to write down these notes in your CW. And later on, I will send you the exercise. Okay, thank you.